Acquisition of signal, Tasmania. acquisition of signal, Guam.
Thank you.
acquisition of signal, Hula.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the webcast for O3B Empower. So far in the mission, we had an on-time liftoff at 6:12 p.m. Eastern Time, followed by successful ascent, stage separation, first stage landing, and 2 second stage engine burns. We're now coming up on the third and final second stage engine burn before the 2 payload deployments. Should be happening in just a few seconds. There is the start of that burn. And this is a quick burn and should last around 30 seconds. There was second engine shut off there for the third time. Now we were waiting on confirmation of a good orbit from the teams.
Nominal mission orbit insertion.
There is that confirmation of nominal orbital insertion. And as a reminder, the O3B satellites are still attached to Falcon 9's second stage. The first payload deployment will occur in about 3 minutes from now. Now, as mentioned previously, our customer today is SES. SES's O3B Empower communication system comprises an initial constellation of 11 high throughput and low latency satellites, as well as an extensive ground infrastructure. The O3B Empower satellites were collaboratively designed by SES and Boeing, and these satellites are SES's second generation MEO system that has been delivering high-performance communication services since 2014 to customers operating in nearly 50 countries today. Now, the spacecraft deploying today will operate from medium Earth orbit, which is MEO, at 8,000 kilometers from the Earth's surface. Now, as mentioned previously, today's launch is the second of the 5 O3B Empower launches, with service introduction scheduled for later this year. Now we're coming up on the first of 2 payload deployments at T plus 1 hour, 53 minutes and 19 seconds, so a little over a minute from now. And you can see the second stage MVAC engine there on your screen. It is still carrying the 2 O3B Empower satellites. You can see a view of the payload adapter there. We are less than a minute from the first of the 2 satellite deployments. It's worth noting that we previously launched 2 O3B Empower satellites in December of last year. So this launch will mark the 3rd and 4th satellites of the O3B Empower satellite constellation. Everything is continuing to look good on the second stage and the payloads. We're a little less than 20 seconds from that first deployment.
First payload separation confirmed.
You heard that call out with the confirmation of a successful deployment of that first satellite. Now with that confirmation, we do have one more major milestone left in our mission, and that's the deployment of the second and final spacecraft for SES O3B Empower. The second deployment is scheduled to happen in about 6 minutes from now. So in the meanwhile, enjoy the space use once again, and we'll see you here very shortly.
Another
Hello again. We're nearing the end of our mission today for our customer SES. Now, although we didn't get any
signal, Kodiak.
We didn't get any views of the first satellite deployment about 6 minutes ago, we did get good confirmation. We are awaiting the second deployment of the second satellite happening in just a few seconds here. Now, much like that first spacecraft, it's likely we won't get views from the second stage
video.
And
power second deploy confirmed.
But as you just heard, we did get confirmation via telemetry that we did have a successful deployment of that second satellite. Now, with confirmation of that successful deployment, that will end our coverage of the O3B MPower mission. All of us here at SpaceX want to give a big thank you to our customer SES for entrusting us with today's mission. We also want to give a shout out to the Range and the Federal Aviation Administration for supporting today's launch. This launch concludes our 226th overall SpaceX mission to date and our second launch of the week. Now, if you're down for more excitement, Falcon Heavy is actually getting ready to launch in just a few minutes here at the neighboring pad in pad 39A down in Florida. The webcast is already live, so you can hop over there and watch that. But as always, thanks again for tuning in, and we will see you next time.